Hello, good morning student. Today I am going to discuss chapter number 2. As we know that we have completed as a chapter number 1, the name of that chapter is the strength of organic acids and bases. Today we are going to learn chapter number 2. The name of the chapter 2 is this one, chapter number 2, stereochemistry of disubstituted cyclohexane. This is the name of stereochemistry of disubstituted cyclohexane. So that chapter we are going to learn today. So stereochemistry of disubstituted cyclohexane, we have learned or we have studied the stereochemistry of cyclohexane and monosubstituted cyclohexane. We will now discuss the stereochemistry of disubstituted cyclohexane. These exist all types of stereoisomers, that is geometrical, optical, conformational. This type of the isomer, and we will not only consider the stereochemistry of these compound, but will also learn how to decide their relative strength of relative stability of those conformations. So first, before we do this, let us recap some of the term which we have learned in your previous classes, like FYBSC or maybe in a SYBSC. So first of all, this stereochemistry, why it is important, what is the significance of stereochemistry, or what are the aspects we are going to learn under this heading, stereochemistry of disubstituted cyclohexane. When the stereochemistry, it is involved in the isomerism, right? An isomerism means what? The organic compound having same molecular formula but a different structure is known as a isomer, and that phenomenon is known as a isomerism. And that isomerism further divided into two types. Number one is called as a structural isomerism. Second one is known as a stereoisomerism. Structural isomerism means what? Depending upon their different structures, that type of the conformation is known as a structural isomerism. Stereoisomerism means what? The same connectivity but the different order of attachment of atom in a space, that is called as a stereochemistry. And that structural isomerism again further divided into as a 4 to 5 types. Number 1 is called as a chain isomerism, only just a straight chain or some of the branch chain having same molecular formula but different structures are known as a chain isomerism. And second one is maybe as a position isomerism means what? Having a same molecular formula just by changing the position of one atom, we are getting as a different type of the structure is known as a positional isomerism. Now move on to the next one. Third one is known as a functional group isomerism. Functional group isomerism is only having as a same molecular formula, but two different structure having as a two different functional group are known as a functional group isomerism. Then tautomerism, ketoenol form of the structure is known as a tautomerism, and the last one is a metamerism. And either unequal distribution of that group on one side, maybe as on a nitrogen side or in oxygen side, that type of the isomer is known as a structural isomerism. And now move on to the next one is a stereoisomerism. And as we know the stereoisomerism, there is a same molecular formula, same connectivity, but the orientation of the atom in a space in a three dimension is different, and that is called as a stereoisomerism. And stereoisomerism further divided into as a two types. One is called as a conformational isomerism, and another one is called as a configurational isomerism. Again, conformational isomerism means what? Just by rotating as a carbon-carbon single bond, we are getting as a different type of the structure, that is called as a conformational isomerism. And this conformational isomerism, you can observe, you will see in a cyclic as well as cyclic compound also. And next one is called as a configurational isomerism. In configurational isomerism means there is a restriction between that in the rotation. So that type of the conformation is called as a configurational isomerism. And this configurational isomerism again further divided into as a two type. One is called as a cis isomer, and second one is called as a one is called as a optical isomerism, and second one is called as a geometrical isomerism. Optical isomer means what? The compound must possess or must exist as a chiral carbon or a symmetric carbon atom, then that can show the optical activity. Optical activity means what? The certain substance rotating the plane, rotate the plane of polarization through certain angle is known as a optical activity. And this is a one of the important property of the organic compound. And second one is known as a geometrical isomerism. In geometrical isomerism, mainly present in the carbon-carbon double bond. And there the rotation is restricted due to the carbon-carbon double bond. That type of the isomer is called as a geometrical isomerism. And this geometrical isomerism again further divided into as a two type. One is called as a cis isomerism, and second one is called as a trans isomerism. Cis isomerism means what again? Cis means with respect to the carbon-carbon double bond. If similar group, identical group are on the same side of the carbon-carbon double bond is known as cis isomer, and whereas trans isomer means what? The similar group or identical group are on the opposite side of the carbon-carbon double bond is called as trans isomer. And generally trans isomer are more stable as compared to the cis isomer. And this is a whole story about the stereochemistry. Now coming back to our original point, what is the stereochemistry? Here, the stereochemistry means the branch of chemistry that deals with the description of the orientation of the orientation of the spatial arrangement of atom in a space, or that the study of study of arrangement of atom in a molecule as they undergo chemical reaction. So that is called as a stereochemistry. And there in this chapter particularly we are going to study the stereochemistry of the disulfuted cyclohexane. And you might be knowing the structure of cyclohexane. Cyclo indicate as a, this is a cycle, this is the structure of cyclohexane. And cyclohexane, this cyclohexane at room temperature present in the various forms are there by rotating as normally. This is a general representation of this. While studying as a stereochemistry, you normally this blackboard or whatever paper, these are two-dimensional entities, and we have to visualize the molecule, because molecule are present in a three-dimensional entities are there, and therefore you require a lot of imaginary power. And if you understood that why stereochemistry is useful in organic chemistry, because by stereochemistry, suppose one of the compound has a R configuration, it may be the useful as a man, as a medicine, or useful as a medicine or as a drug, but its analog may be as a its enantiomer, suppose as a S configuration. The stereochemistry makes a lot of difference are there, and that's why stereochemistry is highly important as far as organic chemistry is concerned. Normally in the medicines are there, and that stereochemistry is playing an important role, and therefore we are studying the stereochemistry. This is a simple cyclohexane, right? This is a structure of cyclohexane. Six carbon atoms are there. What will be the molecular formula of this cyclohexane? Do you know that? Yes. The molecular formula of cyclohexane C6H12. Now look at here. There are 12 hydrogen atoms are there. Are these 12 hydrogen atoms identical? No. These all 12 hydrogen are, if you write this cyclohexane in a more stable form, there are various forms are there. Just by rotating as a carbon-carbon single bond, we can get as a different conformation, like a chair conformation, then boat conformation, skew boat conformation, half chair conformation. So that type of the conformation you are going to get. But here specifically we are going to consider only as a cyclohexane. Most stable conformation is a chair conformation. How to draw that chair conformation? Look at, this is a chair conformation of this. Now here you can write, this is a carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. These are the six carbon atoms are there. Now look at, there are the six carbon atom, and each carbon atom has two hydrogen atoms, and that two hydrogen atom, how they are showing or how they exist in the cyclohexane. This is a chair conformation. How do you know this is a chair conformation? Because the chair conformation, look at here, carbon number 2, 3, 5 and 6, they are present in the same plane, in the general plane. And one carbon atom which is above the plane, and second carbon number 4 which is below the plane, so that is a general. And both conformation of this, maybe as a, you can write as a, this one is a boat conformation. Look at here, this HF, and this is called as a HF means what? This is known as a factful hydrogen atom. Factful hydrogen atom means what? They creating as a lot of steric interactions are there. Once the steric interaction increases, the internal energy increases. Hence, and in general, if the internal energy or the energy increases, the stability of the organic compound goes on decreasing, and that's why boat conformation is a less stable as compared to as a chair conformation. In a chair conformation, you look, if you See carefully, what do you observe here? There will be a no such type of the interactions are present in the chair conformation. Therefore, chair conformation is always more stable than the board conformation. Now, how do you represent the two hydrogen which are present on the carbon number one? Now there are, see, out of 12 hydrogen atom, 6 hydrogen atom are present in an axial position and 6 hydrogen atom are present in an equatorial position. Again, axial hydrogen atom means what? The hydrogen which are perpendicular to the general plane are known as axial hydrogen atom. And equatorial hydrogen atom means what? Equatorial hydrogen atom means bond means they are projecting outside the plane, that are called as a equatorial bonds, axial bonds and the equatorial bond. Now look at carefully here. I am trying to draw the axial bond, six axial bonds here. Now look at, they are perpendicular to the general plane, so I am putting here one hydrogen atom which is exactly perpendicular to this plane, the carbon. Look at the carbon number 2, and then another hydrogen atom which is also as a perpendicular from bottom, you can see clearly. Now the carbon number 3, the another car hydrogen atom exactly perpendicular to this, you can show like this. And look at the carbon number 4, there is a hydrogen atom which is present at axial position. Come to the carbon number 5, there is a hydrogen atom axial which is exactly perpendicular to the plane. Carbon number 6 again is a this hydrogen atom, all are the axial hydrogen atoms are there. And if you, what do you see here or what do you observe here? Look at, all are perpendicular, 3 from the above alternatively placed and 3 from the below, means they are perpendicular to the general plane. That type of the hydrogen or bond is known as axial one. Now equatorial, 6 are the equatorial hydrogen atom. How do you represent here? Now look at here at carbon number, this one which is above the plane, equatorial, should be below the plane, and that you have to draw equatorial is like this. At carbon number 2, how to represent it? You can represent the hydrogen atom. This is the equatorial, this one is the equatorial. Now at carbon number 3, one axial is above the one, so equatorial should be below the one, and that is shown like this. At carbon number 4, axial is below the one and equatorial should be above the one, right? And now at carbon number 5, axial is above the one and equatorial should be below the plane. And now here at carbon number, axial is below the plane, so equatorial should be above the plane. So this is a representation of 6 axial and the 6 equatorial. And you have seen in SYBSC monosubstituted cyclohexane. Suppose as a, you have a monosubstituted means only one of the hydrogen atom which is present here, suppose as a methyl. This is called as a methyl cyclohexane. I am drawing here, two structures are there. One is this one and another one is this one. Look at here. I am placing methyl group at equatorial position and here I am placing the methyl group at axial position. So two are the different isomers. One is the axial one and one which is equal. Now among these, what do you think, which one is the more stable? Now we are considering as a relative stability of this. Relative stability of this monosubstituted, which one is a stable one? Remember one thing, bulkier group always prefer to stay in a stay in a equatorial position. Look at here, methyl group, bulkier group, which is present at equatorial position. Therefore, it is more stable than the this one, and this is a less stable. Why this one is a less stable? Less stable because in a axial position, look at 1, 2, 3, at 3 position there is a hydrogen atom, 1, 2, 3, there is also a hydrogen atom, they are nearer to this type of the interaction is called as a 1,3 diaxial CH3H interaction, and 1,3 diaxial interaction, they shows 1.9 kilocalorie per mole of van der Waals strength, means it is an internal energy and therefore it is a less stable, multiple by 2, so you will get 1.8 kilocalorie, but here you will get as a 0 calorie, and therefore this conformation, axial methyl conformation, is a more stable as compared to as a this one. This is a general what we have talked, the introductory part regarding the stereochemistry of the stereochemistry of that organic compound. Now let us look at our original one. What is that? Disubstituted cyclohexane. And as we know that here, disubstituted cyclohexane, suppose as a how many structural isomers do you get here? Disubstituted, suppose we have a cyclohexane is a this one, and cyclohexane this one, suppose as a I am putting the one of the hydrogen atom by X group and another hydrogen atom by another group, so this is called as a 1-1 disubstituted cyclohexane. This is a structural isomer we are talking about. How many structural isomers do you get for disubstituted cyclohexane? I am one of the structure I already drawn here. Similarly, what do you think? Structural isomer do you get like this 1-1 disubstituted cyclohexane? Only you have a two options only. You replace the one of the hydrogen atom by X and one of the hydrogen atom by Y. Look at here, 1-1 disubstituted cyclohexane. Similarly, another we can do like this. I am putting here X at this position and Y at a adjacent position. So this type of the isomer, you can call it as a 1-2 disubstituted cyclohexane, right? This is a 1-1 disubstituted cyclohexane, this is a 1-2 disubstituted cyclohexane, and move on to the next structure. X we can put as it is, so Y you can put here, right? So this is a this one, what do you call it? You can call it 1-3 at 3 position, and therefore 1,3-disubstituted cyclohexane. This is a third, and another structure we can draw here, this one X I am putting as it is, Y namely exactly at the opposite position at para position, so this one is called as a 1,4-disubstituted cyclohexane. So these are the four structure. Out of that four, can you draw any other possibilities here? No. Only four possibilities are there. 1-1 disubstituted cyclohexane. This one is a 1-2 disubstituted cyclohexane. This one is a 1-3 disubstituted cyclohexane. And this one is a 1-4 disubstituted cyclohexane. These are the three possibility. These are the four possible structural isomers are possible, and so we can draw here. Now, what we are going to learn here, disubstituted cyclooxygen, this is a structure, and here we are going to consider only as a most stable conformation, which is a chair conformation. Just now we have seen why chair conformation is more stable than the other conformation are possible, but we are going to consider it here only as a chair conformation, right? Now, and what are the point we are going to learn here? And this chapter is very, very important as far as the exam point of view, because this the mark, weightage of mark in exam, the question number one mark questions are there. So one question always appear from this chapter. And now look at the chapter number, I think question number 3, there is a 5 mark questions are there. Question number 3, while setting, if you look at as a 3 to 4 years question paper, you will find question number 3 always consists 5 mark questions are there. 3 questions are there, and out of that 3 question, 1 question must be from this chapter. So what type of the draw the chair conformation of cis-1-2 disubstituted cyclohexane and comment its optical activity and the relative stabilities. That type of the questions are there. Or why 1-1 disubstituted cyclohexane is optically active, because here what the stereochemistry we are stereoisomer we are going to learn. Number one, that is a geometrical isomerism we are going to geometrical isomerism we are going to learn here, whether out of that four, whether this one shows that the geometrical isomerism or not, that we are going to find. Geometrical isomer means what in the case of cis and transform, how to represent cis, how to represent trans, that type of the thing we are going to learn in these cases. Now, second point to discuss with respect to this stereochemistry of disubstituted cyclohexane is a optical isomer. Optical isomerism means what? Optical activity is the one of the property of the organic compound, and the optical activity is measured by an instrument is known as a polarimeter, and by using that one is experimentally we can very easily find out whether the given compound is optically active in nature or optically inactive in nature. That's the thing. And now third point we are going to study here, what is that? That is a conformational isomerism, right? Conformational isomerism, whether it's a enantiomer, diastereomer, that type of the thing. And the fourth point we are going to learn, that is a relative stability. Relative stability. These are the points we are going to learn one by one. I think in the next lecture we are going to learn, we are going to start as a 1-1 disubstituted cyclohexane with and we are going to study, or we are going to discuss, these are the point, whether they show geometrical isomerism or not, optical, whether it is optically active or optically inactive, whether there is a conformational isomerism possible or not, and then relative stability, suppose as a x and y, how, whether in the chair conformation which conformation is more stable or less stable, that type of the comparison study we are going to learn. I think with this, let us stop today here. Have a nice day. Thank you.